Rivermains are some of the most subterranean-dwelling neckbeard katana masters that League of Legends has ever seen. I mean, hey guys. Hey, what's up, Sockjaw? So I posted yesterday's video, and I don't know, it just kind of fucking blew up, okay? Like, in less than 24 hours, it got about 100,000 views, which had me kind of like, hey. So I figured you guys actually enjoy the hate somewhat, although honestly, I'm dealing with forces way beyond my fucking comprehension. By fucking with Riven means, yo, hold up, we gotta get this point. Oh, okay. Interesting. Keep it going. Oh, there we go. Oh, cancerous champ. I'm dealing with forces way beyond my fucking comprehension by messing with Riven means. I'm actually putting my life in fucking danger by doing this shit, okay? Because they're some of the most cutthroat types of players on this game, alright? Guys, I'm gonna need you to actually fucking like this video. I need my Sockjaw to come through and protect me against these Katana Masters. So Riven for me is a champion that has been entirely ruined by the goblin-like creatures that actually play her a lot. That's right, the people that main this champion, the behavior that they exhibit, and my experiences with the people... Oh, shit, hold up. My experiences in the past have been so outright horrible that I literally don't even want to play the character really because I'm afraid that people will associate me with those kinds of toxic people. Not even farming, just farming kills. Kappa. I mean, I'm pretty fucking toxic, right? But at least I'm toxic in YouTube videos rather than in all chat. And yeah, as much as I actually think Riven is a cool champion, and I'd be down to like learn how to do the attack animation cancel, I mean, even considering that there is now a new attack animation cancel that has her outputting her fucking entire combo in about a split second, it is retarded. It's completely retarded. It's never gonna happen. Riven for me is like the story of Romeo and Juliet. If Romeo was a 23-year-old man-child with a shit haircut who plays video games for a living, and Juliet was a puppet that had a million flaming retards pulling the strings. We just can't be together, and it's something that I have grown to accept. My god, she's easy. What the fuck is this shit? Is this what playing Riven actually feels like? Even as I play this character for the sake of this video, man, I feel really, really uncomfortable. I feel fucking judged by everyone in this game just for my choice of character. Honestly, every motherfucker thinks that they're box in this character, and it's honestly no surprise that the majority of the people that play her are complete fucking knuckle draggers. Considering her playstyle completely encourages you to fling yourself under towers like this, like you have absolutely nothing left to live for. And this can lead to two different scenarios depending on what team you're on. If the enemy Riven does this, you can bet that they are tower diving your singed at level 1. Only to 2v1 you at level 3, only to come out of lane 11-0 and crush your entire enemy team. She lifesteals 90% of her HP in one auto attack. As well as this, all of her spells are on a 0.1 second cooldown, so you can't even hurt her. That other scenario though, is when you have a Riven on your team. Your Riven will be tower diving the singed level 1, only to die. Only to 2v1 at level fucking 3, and die. Only to come out of lane 0-11 because they died. This Riven is a Riven that you can always go to check what they're doing in top lane and you'll see them like fail to go over walls like when you go like this. Yeah, I did it. I didn't fuck up. They're trying to invade the enemy's buffs and they end up getting fucking 1v1'd by Ezreal jungles. Or something. They become completely useless because all they can really do is just throw themselves at the enemy team and hope for the best and try and do damage, and it just does nothing at all. And I think this largely comes in part due to the fact that in all the times I have seen Riven played over the years, okay, I've played League of Legends for a really, really long time, but I don't think I have ever actually seen her play tanky. And she isn't made for that at all. I'm not saying that she should build tanky. I mean, you just build her damage, and you kind of just hope for the best. But my question as to why this is the only acceptable thing that you can actually do on the character. Why is it like that? Seriously, like, would it fucking kill a Riven to get, like, a Randuin's? I honestly don't know that much about the character. If she's getting shit-stomped by a Tryndamere, Would a random wins help, or would it just completely destroy your entire game? I don't even understand. When I play League and I'm in top lane and I do shitty, if I'm on a character that can build tanky and I'm doing badly, I kind of take that as my, take that as like the cue to start building tanky. If I go 0-3 in lane and I get demoted from top lane carry to top lane tank, and it is basically my job to build some tanky shit, basically just spend the rest of the game soaking up as much damage as I possibly can to try and stop the people that might actually be doing well in my team from dying because the enemy team are too busy wasting all their shit on me, who's fucking 0-3 or 0-4 and mostly completely useless. But with Riven, I wouldn't even suggest building to a Riven player that they get an actual tanky item, because I'm scared that they might actually physically rage quit the game if I even so much as hinted that they do such a thing. These are the kind of people that quit fucking ARAMs. They genuinely rage quit ARAMs. These are the kind of motherfuckers who rage quit custom games against bots, right? And I have no idea why the character of Riven is so associated with shitty attitudes. But honest to fuck, it feels like it's true, you know? Literally a few days ago, I made a video about Blitzcrank mid, okay? It was a silly, silly video. It was just a fun little thing I was doing Blitzcrank mid. You might have watched it. If not, there'll be like a link at the top left of the screen if you click on the eye. I did a video on Blitzcrank mid and I had a Riven top lane. And I captured footage of Riven telling me to die of cancer, telling me to like die in German, and then she ended up actually just rage quitting the game. So you're probably wondering like, Ross, what did you do to make that Riven rage quit? Did I tell her to fucking kill herself? Did I maybe steal all her CS, then fly to her house and hate fuck her mum? No, I'll actually show you the footage of exactly what I did. Here we are. There we go, and let's just walk out. That was a good gank, not too bad at all. I'm getting reported. I'm not quite sure what for. Did Riven die? I didn't know that. I didn't know she died. Yep, I went top lane, I killed Rammus, and then I left. That is it. That is literally fucking it. The response to that was to tell me that I'm reported. It was to tell me that I'm gonna get cancer and some other angry German shit. Now, lads, I don't fucking know about you, but that seems like a disproportionate amount of toxicity for what I actually did. And it does seem like there's a pretty disproportional amount of Riven players that are actually toxic as fuck. Whenever I play a game in ranked and I see a Riven main in my team, I feel like I have to tiptoe around their feelings like I'm babysitting like a fucking 8-year-old. Someone who just really doesn't have a grasp on their emotions properly, and that I have to like be very, very nice to them. I think we all have one of those friends who gets like offended a little bit too fucking easily. Yeah, that's basically every fucking Riven player I ever come into contact with. I feel like every Riven main I end up seeing is literally two deaths away from throwing their toys out the pram and fucking alt F4ing. Now this, guys, can benefit us. If you see a Riven main in your game, camp them. If you see a Riven main in your team, camp them. Camp the fuck out of them. But for the love of God, don't steal any of their kills. Don't take any of their CS, or they will completely close the game down. And there's also, there's more than one character like this in League of Legends. Riven and Yasuo, I mean, what the fuck is the deal with it? These two types of characters, where the people that play them have to have the champion name in their fucking summoner name. Like, legit, if you see a Riven main, there's a 70% chance that that person has Riven in their summoner name too. Like, this doesn't happen for any other character. Like, you don't see people playing I Love Mordekaiser their fucking 69. Oh shit. Oh my god, am I fucking beast mode right now? You don't see people walking around playing as fucking Lucian as my daddy. You don't see anything like this, but for some reason it's completely normal for a Riven main or a Yasuo main to be doing something pretty similar to this. Regardless though, I truly apologize if you are part of the 1% of Riven mains who are not like what I've basically described this entire video. But I guess my challenge to you is to be super extra nice in your game and have a smile and treat all your fellow summoners with all the respect that they truly deserve, even if they're fucking 0-8. Because honestly, your entire team fucking hates you before you've even opened your mouth based on your choice of character. Don't even pretend Like, I'm wrong on that one as well. Oh! I'm out of base. But aside from that, thank you guys so much for supporting me on the last one. Don't forget to smash that motherfucking like button to protect me from all the new Riven mains that are probably going to attack me. If you're new to the channel, join the sock drawer by clicking subscribe. And I'm basically never ever going to play Riven ever again. Because I kind of am doing well and I don't want to encourage myself to do this. So I'm never playing her again. This is fucked up. Regardless, guys, see you later. See you tomorrow.